folks, so I'm back up here releasing Catherine back into her native habitat after I replaced her transmitter. And I'll let you take a look at her now. Margaret has her and is going to release her, but let's look at her transmitter first. Here's her transmitter. It's really large. And I'm kind of unhappy with the size of this unit, but it does have about a 3-year lifespan, and it's within the weight requirements for Catherine. She should be able to carry it just fine, but it's just really big. It's a different company that I've never used before, but we're going to give it a test and see how well it works. They're highly rated, so let's see how it goes. All right, Catherine, it's time for you to go home. This is right where I found her. She'll immediately know exactly where she is, and there she goes. And you see the transmitter is getting grass wrapped around it. I was kind of afraid that may happen, but it is dry grass. She should be able to bulldoze right through it and shouldn't have any trouble. I've never found a turtle stuck or snagged in grass or anything. The only time I've ever found a turtle that was caught in anything was Mrs. Bones, who was trapped in some old fencing material. So that, of course, is not a natural item that you would find in the forest. All right, Catherine. She's hiding, of course. But we're going to leave her alone and go find Zoe and maybe Utsanati and maybe Jimmy, depending on how much light we have left. So we'll see you in a week. Good luck. Oh, I forgot to mention. Okay, so Catherine here, where she is now is very unusual for this time of the year. It's up here on the side of this slope above what I call the turtle sanctuary, this little bowl down in here where we found so many turtles so many years ago with John Rucker and his turtle dogs. She hibernates, however, way over there near that bright red tree. That way. She hibernates over there, and it's a good 300 or 400 feet to her hibernation area that she's used for the last 4 years. So what is she going to do? We'll find out. That's why we do this. I mean, I could have taken her back and dropped her into her hibernation area, but that would have been, you know, tampering with her natural movements. Of course, taking her out of the wild is tampering with her natural movements too, but we'll see what happens. It's all in the name of science. See you, Catherine. She knows where she is. You can be sure of that. So we're on the trail of Zoe now, and we're taking kind of a roundabout way to get to her. We're cutting over the mountain, down the ridge, and following a nice, easy walk on the road. Because the other day when I located her, she was about 30 feet off of this gravel road. So it'll be interesting to see where she is today. Couldn't ask for a more beautiful afternoon for snake tracking, huh? We'll find that snake. She's probably not too far away, but the mountain here, we're up on top of the ridge and drops off steeply on both sides. And I have a feeling she's somewhere near where she was about a week ago. So we'll find her. Yep. I think she's probably in the same place or close to it.
All right.
Somewhere in there is where you're going to go. You lead the way. Yeah, she may have moved, but shoot back that way just to be sure.
Yep.
Yeah, I think she's moved back this way, so follow it.
I think I'm gonna go down and sort of cut that direction. Seems to be.
Yeah, I would point it towards a lot of teeth and narrow it down a little bit. Game. And make sure when you narrow it down, don't go so far that you don't hear anything. Yeah. Slow down on your spin just a little. You might go right through it.
All right.
She may have moved back up on top of the ridge. Take advantage of the sun.
Ooh, I'm low crawling.
Yep. What do you
got? Oh, she's still
loud.
I'm gonna get to where I can stand. maybe that way? All right, lady.
Well, she's
where
somewhere
are ya?
Right down in here. You know what you got the game.
Ooh, there's a fresh shed. Ooh. Or is she halfway out of that? That's very fresh.
Is it Zoe? Good spotting, by the way.
Thank you.
It is definitely a rattlesnake skin. And I can't tell if it's Zoe because the part of her body that where the transmitter is, well, actually it's a little older than we thought because look how it's all deteriorated.
Yeah.
Here. But the transmitter would have been, the scar from the transmitter would have been right in here. Hang on, let me look at her pattern real quick. Oh, it's Zoe.
It is.
Yeah, you see this telltale Y-shaped?
Uh-huh.
That Y-shaped chevron? That's Zoe. She has a very telltale about two-thirds of the way down her body. So cool we found one of Zoe's sheds.
That's awesome. So maybe She did shed right before the rain, and it got sunny enough right there that it dried out today.
You know, it's possible because this is really damp inside here, and it's still very flexible.
Mm-hmm.
But these holes in the bottom make me think it's older.
Mm-hmm.
It's interesting. Anyway, let's find her. She's not far.
All right, girl.
She's really close, and watch your step.
Mm-hmm.
Probably in this debris pile right in front of us.
Mm-hmm.
Just watch your step. Faded out. Yeah, she's somewhere right here. Oh wow, it's really strong right there. Yeah, oh wow. Where are you, snake?
Below your foot.
That's what I'm thinking.
She's right here.
Mm-hmm.
And she is staying quiet because she doesn't want to be bothered.
Mm-hmm. Is she behind us? Point your antenna behind us just for good measure. Yeah, she's over here. Somewhere. You see, like, there's holes like that.
I know, easily, just... Mm-hmm. And as much as I don't want to bother her, part of me wants to poke a stick around just a little bit to know where she is. But I don't want to bother her.
I think that's probably a good plan. It'd be nice to see her, but it's nice to know that she's here.
I think she's snuggled down.
Yeah, me too. Well, while you keep looking, I'm going to get out the data collection here.
Okay. Well, at least we found a really recent shed, so we know she's doing well.
Exactly.
And she came up for part of a day or two ago to shed, and then went right back down.
Mm-hmm.
All right, are you satisfied with this location?
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, you're welcome to keep looking around, but I have a feeling...
I just don't want to stress her out, and I don't want to get myself accidentally bitten if I peeve her off.
Well,
so.
I don't want to accidentally step on her.
Yeah.
Okay, so we found Zoe, and she had moved about 170 feet back to the southeast, going towards the location where she spent the entire summer. It's interesting. Now I'm really beginning to think she is going to stay up here all winter. We did find a really cool thing, though, in that snake, skin we found. It was from Zoe, had her markings on it, so that was really cool. Thanks to Margaret back there. But that's it for snake and turtle tracks for today. We're not going to be able to find Utsanati or Jimmy today because we're running out of light. So we'll see you next time.